Hello and welcome. You're logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com, the only portal for news from India, America, Canada, Punjab and Gujarat in English, Punjabi and Gujarati with a list of well-established businesses and resources that you may need. I am Sangram Singh Rathore and today's headlines are: In India, separatist groups called for complete shutdown on Sunday in Kashmir and President Ramnath Kovind has given assent to the Fugitive Economic Offenders Bill. In America, Russia has appointed actor Steven Seagal as a special envoy and President Donald Trump has criticized NBA star LeBron James. In Punjab, 14 Britain youths will tour the state and the centre is evasive on Rs 31,000 crore food credit loan waiver. Stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com and I'll be back with all the news that's important for you from India, America and Punjab. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from India are: Separatist groups called for a shutdown in Jammu and Kashmir on Sunday against the petitions in the Supreme Court challenging the constitutional validity of Article 35A of the Constitution. The article grants special rights and privileges to permanent residents of the state. President Ramnath Kovind has given assent to a law that will deter fugitive economic offenders from evading legal process in India and fleeing the country. Offenders like liquor baron Vijay Mallya and IMN Ter Nirav Modi, wanted in cases being probed by the CBI, are out of India. Several Supreme Court judges are upset with the government. This is for altering the seniority of Justice K.M. Joseph in his appointment notification. They are reportedly planning to meet CJI Deepak Mishra and lodge a complaint about what they said was the centre's interference. BJP Chief Amit Shah on Sunday took on the opposition for playing vote bank politics over the contentious NRC issue. The BJP president asked the Congress, the SP and the BSP to clarify on whether they want illegal Bangladeshi immigrants to stay in India or want them to be evicted. President Ramnath Kovind has met Karunanidhi, the leader of the DMK party, at the Chennai hospital where he has been receiving treatment for about a week. Karunanidhi has largely stayed away from active politics since he underwent a tracheostomy in 2016. As many as 21 public sector banks and 3 major private sector lenders collected a whopping Rs 5,000 crore from customers for non-maintenance of minimum balance in their accounts in 2017-18. The SBI has suffered a net loss of Rs 6,547 crore during 2017-18 due to the issue. Due to severe weather conditions, over 200 Kailash Mansarovar Yatra pilgrims have been stranded in Nepal. They are stranded in the Simikot and Hilsa region of Nepal. Earlier in July, several pilgrims were also airlifted after they were stuck due to the same reason. Himachal Pradesh is promoting the cultivation and conservation of medicinal plants by encouraging farmers to cultivate them. Under the National Ayush Mission, the government is providing financial assistance for which farmer clusters have been set up. Virat Kohli is now officially the number one test batsman in the world as per the latest ICC rankings for test batsmen. He overtook Steve Smith after his performances in the recently concluded Edgbaston Test against England. Actress Sonali Bendre, who is undergoing treatment for her high-grade cancer, has said that she is happy and staying positive by looking for joy in every moment. Her good friend Suzanne Khan and Gayatri Oberoi visited her in the US ahead of Friendship Day. Bendre thanked her friends for being her constant source of strength. Stay tuned to Indian Times Daily as the news from America and Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from America are: Moscow has appointed US actor Steven Seagal as a special envoy to deal with humanitarian links with the US. The under siege star remains hugely popular in Eastern Europe and was granted both Russian and Serbian citizenships in 2016. President Donald Trump has posted a scathing tweet questioning LeBron James' intelligence after the three-time champion said that the president was using sports to divide people. However, First Lady Melania Trump praised James for his new public school for underprivileged children. Hurricane Hector has gained strength as it headed across the Pacific, threatening to hit Hawaii's Big Island and possibly its active volcano. Hector grew to a Category 4 hurricane with sustained speed of 130 miles per hour as it moved westward at 12 miles per hour. Small scuffles broke out as police in Portland, Oregon deployed flashbang devices and other means to disperse hundreds of right-wing and self-described anti-fascist protesters. Demonstrators aligned with Patriot Prayer faced off with Democratic Socialist groups. The National Rifle Association has said that it is suffering from substantial financial issues that could cause the organization to close down. The NRA has lost its media insurance coverage due to an aggressive campaign brought on by New York's Democratic Governor Andrew Cuomo. President Donald Trump has declared a major disaster in California and ordered federal funding to be made available to help recovery efforts in areas affected by wildfires. A seventh person died in a wildfire as a couple of other fast-growing wildfires expanded by more than 25%. The cumulative expenditure loss to the tourism of the Big Island of Hawaii inflicted by the eruption of the Kilauea volcano may reach approximately $200 million. The island may have already lost 38,000 visitors and around $50 million in May and June itself. Armed men attacked a convoy of cars carrying the US envoy to Bangladesh in the capital Dhaka. Ambassador Marcia Barnicat and her security team were able to get away unharmed, but two cars were damaged. Thousands of students are on a week-long protest calling for safer roads. Cincinnati school teacher Bryce Carlson has set a record for the fastest solo unsupported west-east row across the North Atlantic Ocean and became the first US citizen to complete the feat. The 37-year-old completed the row in 38 days, 6 hours and 49 minutes. Almost four decades after the 1980 workplace comedy 9 to 5 opened, Jane Fonda and her co-star Lily Tomlin and Dolly Parton will be returning together for a sequel. The classic film tells the story of the three secretaries who get even with their sexist boss. I'll be back. Stay logged on to IndianTimesDaily.com as the news from Punjab follows. Welcome back to Indian Times Daily. The top 10 headlines from Punjab are: the first batch of 14 Punjab origin youngsters from UK will visit the state from August 7th to 16th under Connect With Your Roots program. They will visit their ancestral places in various districts and meet friends and relatives of their parents. The union government is non-committal on waiving Rs. 31,000 crore legacy food credit loan on Punjab. Ironically, Chief Minister Amrinder Singh and Finance Minister Manpreet Badal have been claiming that the loan is being settled by the centre. Czech pilot Roman Kramarik has visited the Patiala Aviation Club en route his circumnavigation of the world to mark 100 years of independence of Czechoslovakia. He is flying solo and is expected to complete his tour in 36 days. He will land back in Prague on September 8. Union Food Processing Minister Harsimrat Kaur Badal has alleged that the Congress is deliberately delaying the Rs. 925 crore Ames Bhatinda project. Badal said that the Congress is refusing to give approvals because of petty politics considerations. Aam Aadmi Party MLA Sarbjit Kaur Manuke has accused party rebel leader Sukhpal Khera for running a defamatory campaign on social media against her. Leader of opposition Harpal Singh Cheema has also supported claims of Manuke. Both have announced to take legal action against Khera and his supporters. Former acting Jathedar of Takht Damdama Sahib, Gyani Gurmukh Singh, has been transferred back to Akal Takht as head Granthi. He was among the five high priests who had exonerated Dera Sacha Sauda head Gurmeet Ram Zahim Singh in 2015. A fortnight after local BJP worker Jagdeep Singh was murdered, his family finally performed his last rites. They had relented from doing so after the police secured the arrest warrants of Congress councillor Gurdeep Singh Neetu and seven others allegedly involved in the crime. Pathankot District and Sessions Judge Tejwinder Singh is juggling his time between pursuing LLD and presiding over the high-profile Kathua rape murder case. The Supreme Court had earlier shifted the trial to Pathankot after some political parties and lawyers allegedly created disturbance in Kathua where the case was being heard. Minister of State for Social Justice and Empowerment Ramdas Athawale has asked Dalit organizations to call off their proposed countrywide Bharat Band on August 9th. Dalit leader Athawale claims that the NDA has decided in principle not to tinker with the SC-ST Act. The immigration authorities at Sri Guru Ram Das Ji International Airport has caught two Jalandhar residents for allegedly possessing fake tourist visas. The residents were held when they were about to board a flight from Malaysia. The duo was duped by a travel agent who provided them with a fake visa. This is the end of the news bulletin, but stay tuned to IndianTimesDaily.com as news from Bollywood is coming up next. And do visit the resources section on this portal to find the best Indo-American businesses and resources, from accounting firms to wedding planners in your city. All of us at India Times Daily wish that you have a great day.
We may not get to see superstars Salman Khan and Shah Rukh Khan on the big screen anytime sooner. However, Their small screen appearances is enough visual treat for their fans. Currently, Salman Khan is seen hosting reality show Das Kadam, wherein many Bollywood biggies do visit the show for their film's promotions. Of late, Anil Kapoor and Kamal Hassan were seen promoting their respective movies. But this time, it wasn't any film's advertisement. Rather, the grand finale episode and Sunil Grover's birthday that's making news. Yes, Grover celebrated his birthday with the Khans, while Das Kadam witnessed actress Rani Mukherjee accompanied with Karan Arjun and Grover aping Amitabh Bachchan. A special mention to their fan clubs that we got to see the fun night. According to a statement issued on behalf of the makers on Thursday, the Federal Censor Board of Pakistan has banned the film, a courtroom drama around it restoring the honour of a Muslim family accused of treason. Tapsee, who plays a lawyer in the movie, says it's sad to see this ban, as good content won't reach there, she said.
Of course, concern hota hai for the producer that they won't be able to make the money that they could have. And I feel sad that good content will not reach there. So I feel sad for them.
While earlier, director Anubhav Sinha had urged viewers in Pakistan to watch the film illegally if they must. When questioned that he was encouraging piracy, he said,
I am not promoting piracy. Please do not sensationalize a very simple statement. ये एक ऐसा युद्ध है जो उन लोगों के साथ लड़ा जाना है जो दो देशों के लोगों को भाईचारे की बात करने से रोकते हैं तो अगर उसमें कुछ अनफेयर एवरीथिंग इज फेयर इन लव एंड वॉर सो दिस इज अबाउट लव एंड इट्स माई फिल्म आई ओन द फिल्म ऑब्वियसली विद माई पार्टनर मिस्टर दीपक मुकुट मैं बोल रहा हूँ कि अगर आपको गलत रास्ते से भी दिखती है तो देखिए आपको क्या परेशानी है
मुल्क रिलीज्ड ऑन 3 अगस्त दैट ओपन्ड टू अ गुड स्टार्ट